So a blessing includes meaningful, holy touch along with a spoken message that places a high value on them and pictures, fourthly, a special future for them. Psalm 128, your wife will be like a fruitful vine, your sons like olive shoots. When parents bless their children in this way, they're not spelling out for them the things that they want their children to do and to become. That's not what's going on. We don't do what Brian's father did. You're going to be an officer just like me. That's not what this is. That becomes a curse for our children. The Bible says, train up a child in the way he or she should go, not the way you want them to go. And so picturing a special future for them means that we bless them on their journey of discovery and exploration and searching. It means you help them discover their gifts that God has given uniquely to them and their passions and their interests. It means that you as a parent give them rich experiences to try all kinds of things where they can learn things about themselves and about life. And all the while, you are giving them assurances that as they keep God before them in their life, that He will give them a hope and a future. When you let your child know that you believe in their future, you fill their sails with a hope and a strength that hardly anything else can. I'll never forget when I experienced this early in marriage. Janice and I had just started my first church in Minnesota. I finally decided that it was time to write my first book. I've always had wanted to write. This was long, long before our California sabbatical. I've always believed in that great story and that great movie, Ben-Hur, needed a sequel. That movie changed my life, brought me back to Christ in college. And I remember at the end of that movie going, well, what happens next? The fictional hero of the story, Judah Ben-Hur, is a very young man at the end of the story. And so I wondered, well, that story could go on. Well, it was while I was in seminary a few years later and studying church history that all the elements of a sequel to Ben-Hur began to just fall into place. And by the time I'd started my first church, the entire story was here in my head. And I decided, okay, I'm going to write. And I decided to write a screenplay first to flesh out the characters, bring them to life, get them speaking to each other. But 40 pages in and several months in, I got bogged down. And for months and months, I was stuck in the thought of actually finishing this screenplay, let alone writing a novel, just seemed far-fetched, unimaginable. I felt like I was standing, looking up at Mount Everest, thinking, oh, I'll never be a writer. This is beyond me. Well, it was one weekend shortly after that, my parents came to visit, and my dad happened to find the 40 pages that I had written laying around, and he read through the whole thing. He said, what's this? I was a little embarrassed. I told him what it was, and he said, well, what happens next in the story? And so I told him. And I told him of my aspiration to write a book. And a big smile came over my father's face. And he said, son, this is good. This is really good. You're onto something special here. You got to keep at it. I'm telling you, the day after Mom and Dad left and went home, I sat down at the computer again, and I began to write, and I wrote, and I wrote, and I finished that script in a couple months, and then I started climbing up Mount Everest. I began to peck away at the book in my spare time, and it took a year, year and a half, but well, here it is. I got it done, a 400-page novel called Ben-Hur, The Odyssey, and as I was writing it, I reached out with foolish audacity to Charlton Heston himself, the actor, the famous actor who played Judah Ben-Hur, and wouldn't you know, but he wrote me back, and we exchanged three letters over the course of that next year, and I sent him a copy of the book, and I found an agent, and things were moving forward, and things got very close to this happening, and then Charlton Heston announced that he was suffering from Alzheimer's, and everything kind of fell apart, and over the years, I went on writing a few other things. I still believe in this story, by the way. I think there's still room for it. But how did all this happen? How did all this come about? It's because on the verge of quitting, I heard my father say that he believed in my future.